Today there are, this year there are 2,300 students from 300 colleges who are registered for it. Currently Red Hat gives some good awards and so on. Next year I'm going to work with NASSCOM to generate 30,000 projects annually, which are innovative and different. They will still be evaluated as per the normal engineering college norms or university norms, but there they will have a chance to work, not necessarily in a particular area of IT or electronics, but also across multiple disciplines. For example, we are floating about 100 projects in the open source Scilab for developing additional algorithms, which means people in mechanical engineering, people in chemical engineering who run simulations could work together with computer science or IT people. Finding out interested faculty members in individual colleges is not easy. But finding out interested mentors across the country is less difficult. I would suggest that you should neither get encouraged nor get discouraged by one-time interaction. My simple question to you would be, why do you give up? You go to 10 other faculty members. You go to Professor Bhatt. You go to very many others. Try to collect students around you who would want to do this. Not everything needs to be done only in the within the precincts of the defined structure of the course. There was one professor I met in Berhampur in Orissa. He runs a lab on Sunday mornings, an electronics lab, where there is no set experiment. The students come at the beginning of the semester, they decide to build something. It's more like a hobby club, but very focused hobby club. I was amazed. I asked him, how many students come to you? He says, not many, sir, only 10 or 15 out of 80 students. I said, these 10 or 15 are going to make a difference to your school and to themselves. Please watch them carefully. You are doing something excellent. You know what he said? Sir, you are the first one telling me that I am doing something useful. My colleagues and other students laugh at me saying, syllabus ka bahar ka kyo padhata hai? Why are you teaching us outside the syllabus? What is syllabus? I said, real life problems. Tell me one simple real life problem which comes clad in a syllabus, which says, I'm an electrical engineering problem, I'm a mechanical engineering problem, I'm a fields problem. I have not seen any. To solve any real life problem, you have to learn whatever it takes to solve that problem. You will need multiple expertise in multiple fields. That's the reason why our basic engineering education says first year common courses. Tell me how many of you have taken workshop courses seriously and how many of you actually paid $5 or $10 to somebody to submit the final workshop artifact that you have to submit. You see, the problem is on both sides. All that I'm saying is, instead of running a blame game, where as a student I say, look, the teacher is not responding, and as a teacher I say, look, the student was not willing to look at anything else. I say, instead of the blame game, let me find out some good students, some good people, some good ideas. The good ideas and good people, it's first of all wrong to categorize. I will take 2 more minutes to tell you my theory of identifying so-called good and bad people. I applied it to teachers when I was a young teacher. You can apply it to students as well. This is called Fatak's conjecture. It's not a theory because I can't prove it. The conjecture tells you that if you take 10 arbitrary sample teachers, 10 people from the teaching community, and write down the individual characteristics of all those teachers. So somebody is, you know, very hot-tempered, somebody is mild, somebody is very enthusiastic, somebody is dull, somebody is knowledgeable, whatever. You write all the characteristics. So you make a union of all characteristics of these 10 people. It is the conjecture which says that out of this, you can create a small subset, which if it existed with one individual, he will be the best teacher in the world. Out of the same list, you can create another small subset, which if it existed with some teacher, he will be the worst teacher in the world. There is no human being, student or teacher, who is perfect in all dimensions. It is wrong to expect that. But why can't I, as a human being, build on the positive sides that I see with everybody? You know, when I was a young teacher, what I did, it was a funny experiment. People laughed at me. I wrote down such characters. Then I found out the teachers who were good in certain respects. Then I used to attend their classes. There was a professor whose sense of timing was extraordinary. He would start a theorem at 8:30 lecture and 9:25 he will write QED, not artificially, interacting with students. Fantastic sense of it. There was another professor whose board work was superb. Whatever he wrote on the board, if you took down, that reading will remind you of everything that he said. There was another teacher, Professor Bedford was my colleague later, who had excellence in his behavior with students. He was also my teacher. So when I became a teacher, I went and asked him, how did you behave so nicely? And I used to recite an incident, you know, that fellow was asking definitely stupid questions. You know, and he would say, you have a point. However, if you look at it like this, and then he would again explain pain. You know what Professor Bedford said? He says, Fatak, for you and me, that question may be stupid, but for him it is not. Because he is intelligent enough not to ask it if he knew that the question was stupid. He has a genuine problem. And if I ask him to shut up today, he will never ask questions again in his life. Now, if I as an ordinary teacher could benefit from such beautiful wisdoms of people who are around me, I don't have to learn from any great experts, people around me. I'm sure as a student you can do the same thing, but you don't take the trouble, have you? Have you taken the trouble of finding out what is the positive side of each individual student around you? Or you are delighted in saying, "Arey, ye lallu hai, ye galat karta hai, wo theek nahi karta hai." We are very good at finding faults with others. We are very good at patting our backs on whatever little thing we do great. I think we need to do the exact opposite. So, young man, I will try to suggest that stop getting worried about some negative inputs that the system will give you. The system has tremendous potential to perpetually give you negative inputs. Disregard that. But regard the humanity, the sea of humanity that is around you, your students, your teacher. And let me tell you, I have not found a single teacher or a single student who has nothing good to offer. I have learned from every human interaction. So can you. That's my suggestion.
Got here a very big hand. Sponsors HCC of Engineer and the event sponsors Infosys for supporting us, the SJA staff, the Light and Sound Committee, and all the audience who came here and made this a meaningful experience. Thank you very much.